Pondix and FPD. Before that, I have told you. So three parts are there for the FPD. One is the retainer over which you have the abutment. Abutment means over which the retainer is that portion which will cover the abutment teeth. The pondic is the one that will replace the missing tooth, and the connector is that portion which connects the retainer and the pondic. Okay. Now, edentulous space. Edentulous space, according to Siebert, it has been classified into three different groups. What is the class one? Other is the class two defect, and the third, what is the class three defect? This was asked for your previous NEET exam, so that's why I'm explaining it. So class one defect means there is a facio-lingual loss of tissue. Facial aspect, there is resorption, facio-lingual loss of tissue, but the height of the ridge is normal. That is class one defect. Okay, class one defect means there is resorption from the facial aspect, facial or lingual aspect. Okay, class two defect, the width of the edentulous space or the facio-lingual width is normal. There is no resorption at all, but the height has been reduced. That is Siebert's class two defect. Whereas class three defect, it is a combination. Both there is loss in the facio-lingual aspect and also the height of the edentulous space. Clear? So Siebert's classification, class one means facio-lingual resorption is there, but the height is normal. Whereas class two, the facio-lingual width is normal, but the height has been resorbed. Class three defect means it's a combination of both. Okay. Now, classification of pondic. Based upon the mucosa contact, so the contact of the pondic with the mucosa, it has been classified into two types. One with the mucosal contact and other without mucosal contact. So the mucosal contact ones are the ridge lap type, modified ridge lap type, ovate and caudical. Ridge lap, modified ridge lap, ovate and caudical. Whereas the non-mucosal contact type, they are the sanitary pondic and modified sanitary pondic. Okay. So we will discuss in detail each one of sanitary pondic. See, sanitary pondic means there is no contact. So there is a gap between the inner aspect of the pondic and the mucosa. So this space should be 2 to 3 mm. Why it is 2 to 3 mm? Because in Russell steel it is 2 mm, whereas in Tilvan it is 3 mm. That's why I have told it as 2 to 3 mm. There should be a space between the edentulous space and the inner aspect of the pondic. Okay. Now, what are the different names for sanitary pondic? It is also known as hygienic pondic because this area we can easily clean it. Okay. There is adequate space so that you can clean it with a brush. Okay. So it is called hygienic pondic. It is also known as pearl pondic. So it is also known as pearl pondic. In fact, modified sanitary pondic is known as pearl pondic. I will tell you what is the difference between sanitary pondic and modified sanitary pondic. See, in modified sanitary pondic, it is mesiodistally. Mesiodistally, it is convex. Mesiodistally, it is convex. Whereas modified sanitary pondic, mesiodistally, it is concave. Mesiodistally, it is concave. Now, what is the advantage of concave mesiodistal pondic? The advantage is the connector width. Connector width will be more if it is concave, right? Concave means the connector width will be more. And also the sanitary space will be also more. Okay. So there will be increased connector width and also increased sanitary space. So mesiodistally, it will be concave in modified sanitary pondic. So this is sanitary pondic. So again, sanitary pondic, there will be a space will be there between the mucosa and the inner aspect of the, whereas modified sanitary pondic, it will be concave inner aspect. So the conductor width will be more and also more space will be there. So modified sanitary pondic is also known as peril pondic. Coming to saddle pondic or ridge lap pondic. Saddle pondic or ridge lap pondic, it's a pondic with mucosal contact. There is contact over the mucosa. Now its contacts or it fully covers the edentulous space of from the buccal aspect to lingual aspect. From the buccal aspect to lingual aspect. Okay. So it will have a good emergence profile. Aesthetics will be good. The disadvantage is that it is difficult to clean when the food particles get entrapped between this pondic, because buccally and lingually it is entrapped, it's covering. Okay. So any food lodgement between the pondic into the surface, inner aspect of the pondic, it is very difficult to clean. So it is really unhygienic. So in order to overlap this, in order to overcome this, what we have to do is inner aspect of the pondic is modified. Inner aspect of the pondic is modified without any contact. That is modified ridge lap pondic. In modified ridge lap pondic, only the buccal surface or the buccal aspect of the pondic contacts with the mucosa. Lingually, there is an open space. Lingually, there is an open space is there. So this will help to clean the food entrapped between the pondic and the mucosa. Okay, so modified ridge lap pondic are indicated in the labial aspect of the arch. So it is indicated in maxillary labial aspect, maxillary posterior aspect, and mandibular labial aspect. So modified ridge lap is indicated in maxillary labial aspect, maxillary posterior aspect, and mandibular labial aspect. Anterior teeth. Mandibular anterior teeth, maxillary anterior teeth, and maxillary posterior teeth. Okay. And the contact of modified ridge lap, it is T-shaped contact. The labial aspect will have a contact, and lingually only a line of contact through the center of the pondic. Okay, so this is the contact region over the tissue. Now coming to caudical pondic. Caudical pondic is also known as heart-shaped pondic, egg-shaped pondic, or bullet-shaped pondic. So these are indicated in diaphyd ridges in the mandibular posteriors, where aesthetics is not a concern. Okay. So caudical shaped pondic are indicated in diaphyd ridges. There will be only a one point contact over the mucosa. Okay. Okay, so this is the caudical pondic. The advantage is that only a one point contact is there. So it is compared to ridge lap type, it is more easy to clean. Okay, whereas compared to sanitary, definitely there will be food lodgement. Ovate pondic is the most aesthetically appealing pondic. Most aesthetic pondic, it will have a high ridge, which high aesthetics due to high emergence profile. So they are indicated in recently extracted cases. Okay, so in recently extracted cases, what we will do is we will extend the pondic into the extraction socket. So when the socket heals, it will have a good emergence profile. It will completely cover the mucosa or the or the pontic space will be completely covered with the healing mucosa. So there will be a good aesthetic appearance or emergence profile for this type of pontic. So most aesthetic pontic, it is the ovate pontic, whereas most hygienic pontic is it is the hygienic pontic, it is the hygienic pontic or sanitary.